Ladies and gentlemen, here's the second snapshot for Minecraft 1.18, the Caves and Cliffs Update Part 2. 21w38a brings you fixes and tweaks for the new world generation system, new performance settings and improvements, as well as a smattering of bug fixes. My name is slicedlime, and I am here, as always, to guide you through the changes in this snapshot. Let's start with some known issues already presented in the Minecraft.net post for this version. 21w38a is still not compatible with other versions. In fact, you cannot even open a world from 21w37a in this snapshot. To play on the snapshot, you'll have to create a new world. The other known issue is that world saving might take a very long time. This applies when you exit the game, but also during gameplay, when the so-called 5-minute lag hits. So be aware that that lag spike might be much worse in this snapshot. Now with that said, let's dive into the gameplay changes. Sprinting has been tweaked a bit. You used to drop out of sprinting back to walking if you brushed up against the side of a block in any way. That is now changed, so you still lose your sprint if the angle is steep, but as long as you're sprinting only 5 degrees or less into the wall, you'll maintain your sprint. A bug has been fixed where liquids would sometimes just stop spreading. And a problem causing the light to randomly become zero in the sky has also been fixed. In world generation news, strongholds were entirely missing in the previous snapshot, and Eyes of Ender didn't work. That bug has been fixed, so you can now find strongholds again. Spruce trees didn't generate in the grove biome either, like they did in the experimental snapshots. In this snapshot, the groves are actually full of trees. In some places, cave biomes would generate above ground. This happened especially often for dripstone caves, which has been sorted out in this version. Aquifers would also cause some pretty harsh straight borders in unexpected places, which has also been improved in this version. There are also some changes to the ore distribution in this version. Copper now generates up to height 95, which is what was shown in the original chart of ore distribution published on Minecraft.net, but wasn't actually the case in the game because of a mistake. The total amount of copper has also been increased. Lapis lazuli now also generates in blobs, like other ores, instead of being spread out. A couple of sound-related fixes in this version too. In a follow-up to the new audio device switching capability introduced to the game in a previous snapshot, a bug has been fixed where the game would fail to switch to a new device. There's also a new sound trigger where shears will now make a sound when you use them to crop plants. In user interface news, there are two new languages added to the game. They are Lombard and Tokipona. Before we head on to the next section, let me quickly remind you that if you were to kindly bump into that like button under the video, YouTube will be a good pal and show this video to more viewers, so I'd really appreciate it. Anyway, back to the changes. This snapshot also brings several stability fixes as well as a number of performance improvements. One of those fixes is an increase to the amount of threads the game will use at a maximum to do world generation. And note is that this isn't making the game more threaded in general, it is simply allowing the parts of the game that could already run on threads to run on more threads than before. An interesting performance option is a new setting called simulation distance. This separates the distance which the game will use to simulate entities from the total render distance. For now, this only affects entities. Blocks outside this range will still keep ticking. The team is working on making the new setting apply to this as well. Finally, I'll mention that telemetry has been added back into the game. The previous telemetry, the so-called snooper service, was removed in Minecraft 1.13 when the European GDPR law came into effect. Data is currently only sent when loading into a world, and only from players logging in with a Microsoft account. And that's it! My thanks for the top tier viewers of you who watched all the way to the end, I appreciate it. If you don't know how to get a snapshot, I've got a video for you right here. And if you liked this video, maybe you'll also like this one. There are now some resources that can only be acquired by trading with the Wandering Trader. So, while you probably never really wanted it before, there's now a good reason to try to get as many wandering traders as possible. So, you've picked your spot, let's build it!